It's 9 p.m. Pacific, midnight Eastern, and it's time for the show that brings you the best deals in vaping, coming at you from the Vaping Underground live network on Vapers TV. I'm your host and deals diva, Tiger Tiger, and with me as always is the illustrious, opinionated, and devilishly handsome Vapor Joe. So, settle in for 90 minutes of interactive, informative, and money-saving vape chat. Welcome to Done Deal.
I forgot married.
Yes, I guess you are the illustrious, opinionated, and devilishly handsome, and married Vapor Joe.
There you go, there you go. All right, guys, can you hear us? Test, 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 1, 2, 3. One's in a row.
Sounds like Mrs. Patner, D. Millen says. Yeah, that still blows my mind. I'm like, Joe's mom's here?
Well, yeah, it is a little crazy. You might get a little echo from us because we are in the same room, but at the same time, we should be okay.
Let us know how it's going. If we need to change some things around, we will do that, and I can mute on as needed.
I'm a little low.
Yeah, I'm gonna bring you up a bit. Try that one.
Hello, everybody. Is that
well,
better?
Now you're deliberately low.
Hello!
Is that better?
Don't worry. Joe's got enough volume. He'll get through. Not to worry.
Yeah, as far as our guest tonight, we're going to bring in Scope. He's going to be coming in to talk about a few things. He was at our reception.
Indeed.
So we'll talk about that a little bit. And, of course, a new flavor. But I'm not going to bring it up until he's in. So now, do you want to do some bait mail, Tiger?
You start.
Okay. Well, I we must be echoing really bad right now. Guys, you're getting a bad echo. No, yes, you fucking pricks. Yeah, alright, somebody's saying very bad echo.
Okay, there won't be now.
Test, 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 1, 2, 3. Okay. Alright, so let's get into some bait mail. No, I'm still getting feedback in my mic. Which means everybody else is getting an echo.
My mic's off.
Test, test, test. Echo, guys. Somebody's saying yes, and Mike, Tiger's mic is on.
Well, bloody hell. Did we tested this earlier, too, and nothing's bloody working. I installed a little app that would let me mute the mic. My only other option really is
test, test, test. Note yourself, when I talk, bring your entire level down. Like via volume. Through VC. No, I mean through VC. Like use the VC volume and bring yourself down. Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
Post office, still paying full price for postage. Well, now there's a better way.
Okay. Everybody's saying no echo, but we'll go with it. You know what it is we're in the same room. I'm loud.
Any letter, any package, using your
whatever just happened now, echo is tremendous. Again.
And now, Spotify listeners get a special offer from stamps.com, including postage.
I could just get up and walk and talk.
Click on the banner or go to stamps.com.
But then I can't show you the product.
Click on the microphone and type in Spotify.
Okay. All right, so I got the new Proveri Radius. This is the new box mod from Proveri. And to be honest, hold on a second. Give me 1 second here. I'm getting very bad echo, so I'm going to just kill my headphone. Okay, much better. All right, so I killed my headphone. Can you guys still hear me, though? Okay, so what I did is I actually just killed the my earpiece, so I can't hear anything. And I'm talking as if I'm talking blind. But you know what? I do it better improv. You know, this is the way we do it. And Tiger, shut up. So anyway, I'm allowed to say that now, because why? All right. So anyway, so I got the new Provary Radius, and what this is a new box mod from Provary. Now, you know, I was really, really excited about this box mod because, you know, I have 6 Provaries. Tiger has bought me the Dragon Provary. I had the Zombie. I've had the regular Provary. I've had that version 2, 2.5, the version 3, which I gave to Rich Kavina. And Tiger's going to write a note and show this. I'm sure Tiger's writing a note to show everybody. There we go. Yeah, exactly. Remember, I have the broadcast open, Tiger, so I can see everything. She's going to be like, help, somebody save me. I'm very, I'll be honest with you, I'm very disappointed in this mod. I paid for this mod, they did not send me a mod, and this is a real review, because all these other people out there that do reviews, a lot of them, like, you know, I don't want to mention any names, but those that got them really early and are talking about how amazing they are, well, they didn't pay for them. I paid $200 for this mod because I believe in Provate. However, this mod is not worth $200, and it has nothing to do with the wattage. It has nothing to do with the chipset. The reason why this mod isn't worth it is because all of this, this whole area here is plastic. Plastic. I bought Provaries because they were metal. They could be run over by a truck. So I'm really going to spend $200 on a 40 watt, well, I did spend $200, but for you guys, spend $200 on a 99% plastic and only 40. See, if it was solid metal, I'd be like, okay, listen, we're buying this to survive the zombie apocalypse. We're buying this because you can run it over with a truck and it's awesome. That's the reason why I bought my Provaries in the past. This is plastic. If this got run over by your car, if you drop this mod, I'm scared it will break. I'm very upset that they're doing this, and this should have been like the $89 version, and then they should have made a 100% metal version that costs $200, in my opinion. I'm very, very, very surprised they went the way they did. There are some pros to this though. I love the 510 connector on this, how you can open it up and, oh, there it goes, on the floor and gone. Hold on. You can clean it very easily. You know, you can adjust it and do whatever. I really love the design. I believe Zen is involved with that. It reminds me a lot of the Z2 system. So that's a bit of a plus. But other than that, this is a really fancy 40 watt mod. End of story. It is not worth $200. Do not buy it. I bought it. I'm very upset with it. And quite frankly, I think Provape should be ashamed of themselves for putting a mod together that is like 90% plastic. Really, it works great. Don't get me wrong. The mod works wonderfully, but I buy Provaries because they're going to last.
Well, Joe, historically, we've always said, you know, since we became somewhat Provary fans, that a Provary is a mod you need to leave in your will. If you drop it on the floor, you pick it up, you check the floor for damage, and keep vaping. So, yeah, it sounds like they've really, you know, let that standard go with this new offering.
Right. And, you know, when I saw the video they did, and they're like, it's made of a very high-end polycarbonate. I'm like, fuck! And I just bought the bitch for $200. Like, I'm like, I thought this was like painted aluminum, at least aluminum, something. It's fucking plastic. Really? Fucking plastic. Oh, Provabe, what the fuck is going on with you guys over there? But
well, and one of our viewers is saying DSCL says even the $30 100 watt eye stick, 100 watts, and they made that out of metal. They found a way to do.
The funny thing is this mod right here, which is the Joytech EVIC VT. This feels way more substantial than the ProVary. I mean, ProVape rather. Well, ProVary Radius. This feels way more substantial in my hand than this does. And this cost me $50. This cost me $200. And I really believe this is ProVary's last, or ProVape's last go. I think, I almost think they're ready to get out. Like, they're just, this is their swan song. They're just going to make as much money as possible. This probably cost them $30 or $40 to make. End of conversation. They're going to get what they're going to get, and they're done. Because they need to make a metal edition to stay in the game. Because, I don't know, like I said, I spent $200. I'm extremely upset with it. And I don't know, if anybody says they're not, well, they're lying to you. That's all I'm saying, they're lying to you. So. Now, on to something we do enjoy. Tiger and I were lucky enough to get a couple of bottles of juice. Now, we're going to bring in Scope to talk about what he decided to hook us up with, but we are going to bring up Vaping Watch. Vaping Watch decided to send us some new flavors from T-Max No Frills Mills. Now, of course, these are all day, every day, 30 mils for $6. Super, super cheap. Now, I didn't get a chance to vape these yet. Obviously, we've been kind of busy. But we can go over some of the new flavors that came out. We have a cinnamon dusted donut, which is right here. We have a homemade apple pie, which this one I've had. And this is a great apple pie flavor. For those of you out there who love apple pie, you're gonna love this flavor. Let's see what else is here. A vanilla cream donut. Well, if the donuts hold true, this is gonna be a great, great, great flavor. Let's go on. Oh, I'm sorry. We have a boosted homemade apple pie. Okay. Awesome sauce. I can't wait to try this one because the original one was great. And then we have a maple glazed donut. Oh, okay. Hey, we have a Canadian in the room. She knows a lot about maple. She will be the judge of that one. And
yeah,
then...
I can hardly wait to try that one, actually. When I did post on Facebook about this lovely gift they sent us, you can see the picture there. Six new flavors, his and hers, on each, so we don't even have to share. There's no arm wrestling necessary. And a great big bottle of one of our absolute favorites, the banana dragon, or I'm doing it backwards again, dragon banana fruit. They must laugh at me every time I do that. I think they knew that would trip me up. But and if I may, Joe, it was so kind of them to drop ship separately a nice bottle of Moscato to celebrate with. So thank you to Watch and his team.
Yes, thank you, guys. And finally, the Honeydew Straw Pear. I really want to try this one. It's called Honeydew Straw Pear, so I'm assuming it's a honeydew strawberry pear flavor. Now, I have to tell you, these flavors, as they progress, are getting even more complex, yet the price is staying the same. Okay? And the problem we find with lower-priced juices, like I said, the $6 to $10 for 30 mils, they tend to be, you know, one or two flavors, you know, blueberry donut or blueberry this or strawberry that. They're getting way more complicated now, and I like that idea, you know, that they're able to keep the prices low. And again, in glass. Now, the droppers you guys see, they included them with them. I think if you want droppers, I don't know, they cost, I don't know what the actual cost of the droppers are, but I mean, I think you pay an extra 50 cents or a quarter or 50 cents if you want a dropper.
It's a minimal little fee, and these are great. They'll send these along. Now, the nice part is when you're reordering, you can just move it bottle to bottle. You don't need to replace them every time. But that's one of the cool things, and one of the ways they're keeping those costs down. Letting you move these bottle to bottle saves you a few cents, and, you know, that adds up over the course of a year, right?
Right.
So.
Now, No, Watch hit me up before we got married, and I was like, listen, you know, the last few days has been crazy. You wanted to do a deal. I said, listen, why don't you hold off on your deal? Wait till after we're married. Let's get, you know, all that, you know, crazy nonsense, you know, out of the way. You know, with the, you know, limousines and flowers and all that. When we can get back to business, then we can have a deal, and he's going to do that for us. So he's going to be having a deal coming up in the next few days. We're looking at, I think it's either $4 or $5 a bottle for a 30ml bottle. So just look out for it. He's going to hit me up on Skype, and then we're going to roll it out. So. I'm waiting for Scope to call in.
I've got him. We're just sort of finishing up bait mail, and then we'll bring him in. So if you're at a close, I was just making sure you were done with yours before we bring him in. So pretty much at any time if you want to jump in.
Yeah, bring him in, but then I got to put my
headset back. Joe talked about ours, and we're going to wait till you're here to talk about the last bait mail we wanted to mention. Scope's been so kind to agree to join us tonight because we know we've been pretty quiet about our... there he is. There's that beautiful smile. Let's move you over and let's get a screen cap on you and add you to the skull.
Are you Scope, I have to fix my headset now. Hold on a second. Because I disabled it while midstream, so...
Yeah, condensation, that was all part of Joe and I got together and we developed this evil plan. It was a combination of Jersey Italian food and Mad Scope was the way that we lured her out of Canada, and it worked.
Oh, it absolutely worked. How could it not? I mean, the Italian food, seriously, even my son, and he's tiny, knows the difference and appreciates it. And I mean, seriously, if he ever told me that he would refuse to ship me Mad Scope in Canada, I think that would be it. I'd never go back.
Well, luckily, we always had the Joe Midnight Express packages running up there every once in a while. But now we don't. Now you can just turn around, Joe, and go like this with a bottle. It's a lot easier.
Yes. You know, I'm very. Thankful that you and your wife Courtney were at a reception, while he was there, he introduced me to a new flavor. Now, is this a new flavor?
Well, it's fairly new, and it was funny that you vaped it by accident, because the story was, I don't know what happened, you're where your mod was at the time, but you were kind of like still a little bit stressed. You'd just gotten there, your mod was nowhere to be found, and you're like, I just need to vape. And you, so I was like, quick, give him a mod. So I handed you, I think I handed you this.
The purple with the .com on it.
Oh, was it? Was it?
It was the purple. It was the purple 150, or what? The new Sigelli, and the .com.
All right, so I must have had the tanks flipped then, because so it was this dripper with this mod then. And it just so happened to have Arvin's cookie in it, and you were just like power hitting the thing. You're like, this is really good. I'm like, you're like, what is it? I'm like, actually, that's Arvin's cookie, and I was like surprised by how much you liked it. That was cool.
Well, what is I'm a lime freak,
and I didn't know that.
Yeah, I'm a key lime pie or key lime freak, and now you said it's a key lime white chocolate cookie.
Yeah, and there's a story behind it. Basically, Arvin's, who's in chat right now, hit me up a few months ago, and she sent me this bag of these cookies I never heard of. They're made by a company called Wow Baking. They're gluten-free, so they're somewhat healthy, and they're just these amazing cookies. And the first bag, we were supposed to make the juice off the first bag, and my wife and I, they were so good. My wife and I, I'm going to confess, we just hit like too many of them, and then there wasn't enough left to actually match up. So then poor Arvin sends me another bag of these things, and this one I'm like, all right, nobody touches the bag, you know, and nobody, so we get this right. So I forced my wife and I literally sat there, and I'd make a bottle, and then we had the cookies, and we would take a tiny little bite of the cookie and then try to clear our palate and then vape, and then we would flip it the other way. We'd vape first and then take the bite, And we kept trying to match it up, and we had to do a lot of back and forth, and but we finally got it pretty close to the real cookie. And I got Arvin's to approve them, so I figured.
And I'll be honest with you, I've never tasted a cookie like this before. I'm a big fan of the Papa Cherry, of course, and Mansco, but I like this new addition, the Arvin's Cook. It's COOKEY, so cookie.
Because of the key lime. That was, I think, North Mankato in chat who came up with that idea, just to like kind of enunciate the fact that there's a key lime in it. We made it. We spelled cookie wrong on purpose.
Obviously, but this is going to be a great one for those of you who like citrus. This is going to be a citrus lover's vape. Do I think it's as good as Mansco? No, only because my childhood is about iced oatmeal cookies. But next one up would be this. I do like this better than Papa Cherry, though. Believe it or not.
Wow.
Yeah, I do. Because it's been a while since I've been starting vaping, citrus flavors. I got burnt out by it, and now that I'm back with a bakery, it's very hard to do bakery citrus unless it's like a key lime pie. You know, that's just like the classic. But when you mix key lime, chocolate, and the cookie flavor, it seems to bring out the white chocolate seems to bring out something different completely in the key lime.
Well, I think it softens the sharp edge of it, so it works well. It's not like you would go and clearly spot it. It's not a dominant note. It's more like just doing the job of kind of softening the spike of the lime, keeping it from being too sharp. So I think it works well. Actually, that one I got help even from Nitro and William, because when I was still had that thing in beta, I brought a couple different versions of it to Expo when we were there. So I had Nitro and William and a few other BU people sort of all helped me make the final tweak. So it was nice having the extra help.
Well, absolutely. Whatever they did, whatever you guys did, you made a fantastic flavor. And what blows my mind is there are still combinations out there that have been yet to be explored. Like this flavor I've never tasted before in my life, and I have, I don't know, 5 billion bottles of juice that I've tried in my lifetime, but I've never tried a flavor like that. So that's the way the vaping community rolls. Like, we all think it's been done, and it hasn't been done. And there is proof via scope. Wedding edition, by the way.
Yes, exactly. If I may jump in, I wanted to show you guys the special labels he did for us. This picture's on Facebook for those of you who are in my list. If you're not, hit me up. Ty Katz, and of course 2 bottles of Mad's Goat, because he knows I am hopelessly addicted, and the Pop and Cherry, and the new Arvin's cookie for Joe. But I wanted to draw your attention to this right here on his special custom labels. These are the wedding editions. So of course, being the sentimentalist, is that even a word? Than I am. These bottles will be safe. I think I'll have to get a shadow box frame for them when they're empty or something. But definitely, thank you so much. That is absolutely so sweet of you.
You know what's funny? This is how like OCD I am, and people that watch my show know I'm like a squirrel and I'm a little obsessive about things. And so I actually Googled like what are the go-to fonts for wedding invitations, and I actually had the font, go find the font, and then installed the font on my machine so I could then use it for the label, because I didn't want to just use any like random script font. It had to look like a wedding font.
Oh, that is awesome. And it is absolutely beautiful. That's why I had to bring up the detail for that to show people what you did. It is really wonderful. Thank you.
Elvie says, no way.
And what, I didn't want to bring up the wedding as much, because we didn't want to make a huge thing about the wedding, because as much as me and Tiger our lives are in the vaping community, and they know 99.9% of our lives, we wanted to keep the wedding kind of private, and we didn't go crazy, we didn't go over the top. It was quite modest, actually. So the funny thing is, when we finally posted some pictures, I think more people gave a fuck that I took my hat off than we actually got married.
I saw that.
Oh, absolutely, you could do that. But the funny thing is you know, the vaping community has as much as I've done for the vaping community has done a lot for me. But we, like I said, we kept this wedding itself very modest because I'm in my 40s, Tiger's in her 20s, and
Joe, that was plus 100 points right there. By the way,
I'm married now, so I have to worry about those
things. I started nodding before it really sunk in, and it was like, wait a minute, what?
But these people that pay $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, $80,000, $90,000 on a wedding, that's to me insanity. That's like a brand new Mercedes for one day. I'm like, well, just give me the fucking Mercedes. You know what I mean? Like, for me, mm-hmm. it's ridiculous. I'd rather give my lady, a down payment on a huge home than spend, you know, 90 G's on a fucking big thing of toilet paper. You know what I mean? I mean, that's pretty much what a wedding is.
Yeah.
So, like I said, we kept it modest. It was awesome. We had a great time. We only brought in a few vapors. Smokey was there. Scope was there, his wife. The rest was family. And it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of food. When I left there, oh my.
Yeah.
I couldn't walk.
Yeah.
But, you know, and it was booze and craziness. Everybody was having a great time, but at the same time, we went to keep it low. But as far as sharing the pictures, we kept, you know, again, low key. We wanted to do a few. Tiger, she puts the one she loves the most.
I do. And it was amusing to me that, yeah, most of the comments had to do with, oh my God, we thought, you know, Joe's hat was surgically attached to his head. And no, he cleans up very nicely, I gotta say.
So you're saying I walk around all dirty all day?
No. I'm saying you've got a casual, sort of sporty look that I totally identify with and share. But boy, when you get all dolled up, I'm telling you.
I did a double take when Joe walked in. I
you've seen me with my hat on.
Hold on, like, whoa. He looked very dapper. I was
oh,
like,
oh God,
damn.
Don't say that word.
You look good, man. You did. You look good.
Well, I wear a tux well, but I don't like to walk around. It's not like it's Downton Abbey or anything, but I like to stay casual. I mean, 90% of my life is in t-shirts and shorts or jeans. There are times when we must dress up.
Here you go, ladies. This one's just for you. I'm not... Oh, man, if I can only get the screen capture. There we go. This one's for the ladies. Just let them have their moment. There it is. There it is.
The funny thing about the picture is I'm looking over at Tiger, but I look like I'm ready to kill somebody at the same time.
Yeah.
Like, I'm looking at Tiger and going, this is the last time I'm getting married.
Yes, I agree with Arvin.
This is the first time I'm getting married, and I'm going to... You're going to the grave with me.
Well, this is what I've said for a long time. You have this intensity about you that somebody who doesn't know you could be like, you either want to eat me in one bite or kill me.
Well, actually, I will do both in an evening. Actually, no, I'm kidding. I will totally eat you alive. All right, I gotta stop. You're gonna break me, Tiger.
I'm trying, you know I am, and I keep talking while I'm muted, and I am. You know I'm trying to break you. I try every show. I don't always succeed, but I do my best.
But yes, and Tiger was absolutely beautiful. We got married in my home. We did not go to a church. We had a wonderful reverend, Christian reverend, that came in and married us in my home. And again, it was all immediate family. It was fantastic. And then we just took off, and, you know, 90% of the people. I'm the only one doesn't drink. So everybody got drunk.
I didn't. I was sober right with you, Joe. I didn't have not one drink.
Really? Not one?
All right. Well, actually, the very, very beginning, I had like this much sangria, but that was it. Just because they make it really good there. So I had a little tiny bit. That was it.
Okay.
And I almost forgot about it.
I know my bar tab was 90% smoky.
Yeah, he was right as soon as he walked in. The first thing
he was drinking these things that were like these rice pudding drinks.
He got was called a rum chata rice pudding martini or something like that. It was a crazy looking thing. I was like, oh, Smokey's gonna have a good time.
The Halder asks, no booze for the toast. No, I drank seltzer water for the toast. I do not drink, so. So no booze for me, but everybody else was, and again, Scope had at least one cocktail, but...
Yeah, like sangria, though. Nothing compared to Smokey's rum chata martini extravaganza.
Yeah, so the wedding itself was completely 180 degrees different of who I am. Usually I'm, you know, should have Lamborghinis and craziness and, you know... big pomp and circumstance and 1,000 people, but I thought this time we should be a little bit low.
You know what, Joe? I didn't get a chance to tell you this on Saturday, but it was actually kind of cool that, and I don't think you know this, but like with my wife and I, Courtney and I, we both, when we got married together, it was each of our second wedding, and each of us had previously done sort of the bigger, you know, traditional kind of thing. And we did basically the same thing you guys did. Very chill, just immediate family, a few friends sprinkled in, but not, you know, about the same numbers, honestly, as you had. And you know what? We had a blast. And what I thought was great about that kind of a setup is it's like all the fun without some of the stress of the larger size. Because what happens, like, for you guys being the newlyweds, right? When you have the huge thing, you feel this crazy stress that you have to go and say hi and shake hands and hug and everything, every single person. And what happens if you miss this one? Or is this what you start stressing over the well-being of all 100 plus whatever people, and you end up not actually having that great a time sometimes. So I thought what you had was nice in that it was small enough that you could easily get FaceTime with everybody and didn't have that kind of pressure on you. So, you know, kudos to that. I thought that was awesome.
That's exactly what I loved about it, is exactly what you're saying. I never want to have someone there. You know, you invite the people you love the most, and you want to be able to honor each guest. So it was fun having it be such an intimate affair. Forgetful Red in the room wants to know, Tiger, was your family there? No, unfortunately. I'm from Canada. You know, it's an arduous day of air travel. You don't even want to know what it is by highway to get from my home to New Jersey. My family are a smidgen closer. I live, of course, lived in BC, Canada, and very, very close to Bellingham, close to Seattle, Washington. And my family's from Alberta, that north of Montana, so, you know, Billings would be probably the closest American city that we could talk about to them, although they're a fair bit north of that. My parents are aging, my sister is a very, very busy woman, so it just wasn't in the cards to be able to have that. What we did manage to do is bring in my folks via iPad, the wonders of modern technology. They were able to join us for the ceremony via iPad and even interact. So that was cool. There's a story for Apple. Look how your technology is being used.
Wait. They didn't just interact. Her parents gave her away via FaceTime. The Reverend asked, you know, whom does this, you know, who's giving away this bride, and they were there. You know, I have hats off to you know, Apple. They make a fantastic one-to-one chat system, and it was wonderful. And her father and her mother were there, and they gave her away to the Reverend. So it was really great.
That should actually, I agree, that should be a freaking Apple commercial. Like, that would totally sell a lot of iPads.
You know, I'm a big Android freak, but I'm also an Apple freak, and I have to tell you, Apple has the lock on one-to-one communication when it comes to FaceTime. It is beautiful and just seamless.
Yeah.
And now somebody writes, did the Cub have a good time, Tiger?
Sorry, I had to unmute. Yes, absolutely. Now,
who's the star of the show?
I haven't shared pictures, but I gotta tell you, he was Joe's mini-me. And he was wearing a little tuxedo just modeled right after what Joe was wearing, and he was adorable. After the fitting, when we came back from the fitting, Joe's mom asked me, so, you know, do they look nice? I said, you've got to understand, one of them is the cutest thing you've ever seen in your life, and one of them is the handsomest thing you've ever seen in your life. And yeah, a little scene stealer that one was. And yes, he thoroughly enjoyed himself, though he didn't really want to comply. We intended to have him as our ring bearer and have the little satin pillow and the whole nine yards. He had other ideas and decided to watch cartoons for that portion of the afternoon. But it all worked out, and he was very thrilled to be all dolled up as well.
Yeah, he looked very handsome.
The pictures we have and that our photographer did, it's our son. I keep calling it our son because I'm so used to it. I'm only married a few days. Our son, and I am a father, which is a really surreal thing for me because. Of course, I don't have any children. It was really funny to see how he acted, and he really stole the show. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you know, we didn't want to go on and on and on about it, but we felt we needed to talk about it tonight because you guys have been part of the journey. We only met because of vaping, and all of this is you know all related to the fact that. Years ago, for Joe longer than me, Joe's getting close to 4 years. I just passed my 3-year vapeversary. But so many of you have been a part of that. Tower of Vape is in the room. I've known you longer than I've known Joe. So it's so exciting. And of course, newer friends like Scope. It's so exciting to be able to share this with you guys. And of course, your overwhelming support on Facebook and that. You know, we posted a few pictures and my notifications instantly went berserk.
Yeah,
so
it was crazy.
We wanted to thank you so much. You guys have been so kind, so supportive, so encouraging, and it means a lot. Thank you.
You know, and at the same time we're getting married, Tiny Vapors in the hospital with contractions. So, like, all this wonderful things are happening in the vape community while all these other bad things are happening in the vape community. And I'll be honest with you, for the first time in a long time, most of the things that blow up in the vape community tend to be very negative things. You know, this person blew up in a hospital smoking a, you know, e-cig or the FDA or some other bullshit. It's rare that you see good things. Now, I'm not saying our marriage has anything to do with, you know, with the community at large in the sense that, you know, it's not... I guess it's vape related, but the community, we're part of the community. And it's nice to see, you know, a good news every once in a while, because we're always inundated with all the shit.
I agree.
You know, so,
one sort of closing thought for me is that it's pretty mind-blowing to look at the whole timeline from the very beginnings of the first time I saw Joe was just would be watching Mod Envy. And he was just this guy kind of in the dark. It was very dark back then, almost black and white, or it probably was. I think it was black and white back then.
Yes, it was.
And you were kind of dark and hiding, you know. And then I met you at that meet, you know, the Fight Club meet, as we like to call it.
Yes.
And most of the time that I spent talking to Joe was Joe and I being geeks with our phones. He's showing me pictures of Tiger. I showed him a few pictures of my wife. And,
oh, dude,
you know,
by the way. No.
Yeah, and it was like, that was like, sort of like, you know, so then literally the night that I met Joe, like that was one of the main things like he wanted to share with me was like, you know, showing me pictures of Tiger, talking about Tiger, how they met and telling me the whole story. And to fast forward from that night to being honored to actually be at their wedding was just completely mind blowing. Like if you were to ever asked me in those earlier days if I ever thought I'd be, you know, like that's how things would wind up, I would never think in a million years. So I mean it, I can't put it into words that it was a huge honor to be there with my wife and to see these guys you know become legit, if you will. It was awesome, and it was really well done. It's the way my wife and I did it ourselves, you know, keeping it really kind of small and intimate, and I thought it was great.
Well, thank you, sir. You know, Scope, you are that rare breed in the community. There's very few people that you can find that are actually real people. I'm not saying people in the community are real, but you know, you meet somebody and you hang out with them, and you know, they kind of just come and go. But you're a real person, and of course, has the brightest smile in the baby community. you know, so that's just, if, you know what, I'll be honest with you, if Tiger didn't marry me, she'd probably have married you.
Well, I don't know. If Courtney would have let me, maybe so. Absolutely.
Exactly.
Oh, there's plenty of me to go around.
Oh, it's like that, eh? Well, then.
Well, let's just go.
You're legit, girl.
All right, well, Scope, I know you just did to our show when you were here. You showed up, and it's awesome. Hopefully, we'll get to see you on Halloween. If not, no big deal. We will.
No, it's a big deal. We get to. End of story.
Well, the only thing is, there's these little things. There's a small one, a medium one, and a large one. And they wear costumes, and they like to go to houses to get free candy for people. You know, #free shit. So, you know, we got that to think about. But if we can escape, we will certainly love to join you guys.
Good. Wonderful. Well, the good news is, you see, I'm from Canada. Farther north, it gets dark later. Here, it gets dark so much earlier, you can get all that crap out of the way and still come.
All right.
Well, so go off and enjoy your evening.
You know, I'll give you the angle, Tiger. It's all texting the wife. So just start the texting now and make it work.
All right. Well, I can certainly do that. I will be as convincing as I can find a way to be, because we would love to see you guys
pretty
again.
Pretty convincing. So. All right. Cool.
Well, thanks so much for joining us tonight.
Yes. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Scott. We'll talk to you later. Buddy.
Alrighty.
Wait, let's just gotta kind of be like, all right, back to reality. I'm gonna smack yourself.
Now, yeah, this show, we've killed 45 minutes on bait mail and talking about our personal lives now, and we're lucky we still are holding as many viewers as we have. So, I don't know, Joe, do you want to talk about some deals?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a few out there that I'm really impressed with. There's a really big one that just popped up. Well, I'll get to that second. I want to talk about one that's straight up really cool. It's called the Snowman, the Stormtrooper, by Vapor iJoy. Let's get the link. Go in the room. Oh, thank you, Big Bamboo. Now, this makes me laugh, because people always talk about trademarks and how they respect them. You know, a mod like this is a legit mod. It's its own thing, but they'll still steal somebody else's kind of trademark. And what this is a slightly tweaked Stormtrooper. Now, with the new Star Wars coming out, and I am a big junkie of Star Wars, Tiger will tell you. I see Boba Fett right there. I got an AT-AT over here. I really love this mod, and my favorite, of course, is the black and white version, because it holds true to the Stormtrooper's collars, coming in at just $29.77. Out of America, fantastic mod. It's just straight up dual 18650 box mod, mechanical style, but for the price and for the logo, it's fucking awesome. Now, I know Tiger probably has nothing to say about Star Wars,
it was boring. I'm sorry. I didn't see them as a kid when they were coming out, so it just means nothing to me. I was dragged to later when the next three episodes came out, and I was kind of like, I'm so not interested. And some very important people in my life were that interested and absolutely insisted I had to watch the first three so they could drag me to the next three. Or really, is it the other way around? I guess I don't know, however you want to look at it. And now there's more coming out, and Joe's like, we're so going. I'm like, please take someone that appreciates it.
So Tiger will have absolutely no idea what I'm about to say, but some of you geeks will understand. In JJ Abrams we trust. That's all I'm gonna say when it comes to the new movie.
Alright, you're right. I'm clueless. Just even the brim of my hat didn't save me on that one. It didn't catch it.
Yes, the news trailer. I'm a big reaction trailer watcher. Tiger will tell you, I spent hours watching people watching trailers, seeing them react to the trailer. And the new movie just literally made women and men cry. And I don't know if you can get over that hype. I mean, you can hype a movie so much that it bombs simply because the hype is so high that you can't ever actually get to it. But you know, here, there, and there. We're talking mods right now. That Snowman mod looks really awesome for those of you who love Stormtroopers. It's more of a kind of vinyl figurine style Stormtrooper. Looks really nice. Again, $29.77 out of America from eSig.com. Use coupon code ILOVEYOU and it will get you 5% off anything at the place, not just that particular mod, but anything. And I just think it's really cool and really neat and exciting and just something kitschy for a really, really inexpensive price.
And also available in Tiffany Blue. Am I the only woman in the whole vape community that doesn't give a crap about Tiffany Blue?
Yeah.
Like, seriously?
I'm not really impressed by Tiffany Blue.
The black looks pretty deadly, though.
Yeah, the gold, the pimp gold is okay, but it's got to be the black one. If you're going to get a Stormtrooper mod, it must be black and white, period. You know, that's the only way it can be.
Oh, so I should cancel the order for the Tiffany Blue I got you?
Oh, did you buy me one?
No.
Yeah, it's got to be black. All right, so that's that one. Okay, that's that particular. Now, you know, but a chemical box mods come and go, and let's face it, this one's pretty much just about the logo for those of you who are sci-fi Star Wars freaks. But there's a lot of other good deals going out there. I just wanted to see if this one's still going. It is.
And might I take this opportunity, you know, not to let anyone think that we're taking you for granted, Big Bamboo. We haven't had a chance to mention you in the last several shows. I want to thank you. This guy knows our blogs better than we do some days. And every link, every product, he's got it on lockdown. So thank you so much, Big Bam, for your ongoing support and for staying up so late to be with us.
Yeah. The man works, he's a Secret Service agent. He watches over Obama. And he takes this time out to come and watch Done Deal and Help Us with our links. And that's not a joke, he really does.
Oh my gosh, Joe!
All right, so, I mean, we literally only got like about 35 minutes left in the show, so let's hit it up with some more deals. Another deal from an unexpected location, which would be GearBest. And the reason why it's unexpected is don't follow that link. For some reason, it didn't copy and paste the way I wanted it to. There we go. Basically, what this is GearBest now has an American warehouse, which means if you buy from them and you're American, you will get American shipping, and this particular link will take you to an area where the shipping is free in America. Okay, so you're not going to pay the, you know, $2 or $3 for America, and you're going to get it at China prices. Okay, so everything at this link is in America. You will get it as fast as it is in America to ship from, say, whatever it is, California to wherever, and you don't have to wait for the China shipping times. And I'm looking at some of the prices, and believe it or not, every item on this page is cheaper from America than it is from China or EU, from the European Union. So, for instance, if you're going to buy a, let's just take a look at something really fast. Prime example, IPv4, 100-watt mod, fantastic mod, $56, free shipping out of the United States. Looking at Kanger sub-tank heads, $9, free shipping from the United States. Okay, really, really cheap prices. I think what's happening is a lot of these big China companies are housing their stuff in America so they can ship them quickly to the American clientele. Now, don't get me wrong, you can also buy them from China. You can also buy them from the European Union. They're going to be a little bit more expensive, you know, for those of you, you know, people who live in Europe or what have you. So you have your choice. But for the Americans, that's amazing.
Well, and what's cool to me about this is I've worked as a contractor. I've worked as a shingler. And the joke amongst contractors is, you know, there's price, there's quality, and there's speed. Pick two, because yeah. You're only ever going to get two. And it seems with this USA warehouse, you're getting closer to being able, in at least some cases, to get all three. The best price, the best speed, because it's already warehoused here. And in a lot of cases, the products are awesome. You know, like there's products that come out that we're like, yeah, okay, it's a product and it's worth that and whatever. But now and then you get some of these ones, like I know they're talking about the Sigelli 150 right now in the room, and that's available. So, and I know folks are real happy with that. Scopes is gorgeous.
Yep. There's a lot. I mean, there's a ton of different product out there, but there's a lot of people out there that hate to wait. Now, I'm with you on this. Vapors, we are the most impatient people in the history of the world. I'm the same way. I want it tomorrow. Why? Because we're used to companies like Amazon, where I buy something and I get it in 2 days. You know what I mean? To buy a $60 or $70 mod from China and have to wait, you know, 2-3 weeks, it pisses you off. But you want that low price, so it justifies it. So now, on these specific products, and they're not like shitty drip tips, cartomizers, shit that's not being used. It's very relevant products. You can buy them and get them shipped from America to your location, and you're not going to have to wait for 2-3 weeks to get it.
Well, and Big Bam has a really relevant point. I mean, we've seen this before with a lot of China vendors reading the writing on the wall and warehousing like hot products, current stuff, in the U.S. so that they can service those U.S. customers better. I know Angel 6 has done that, Focal eSig has done that. Now, of course, GearBest getting on that train. And he's asking, is FastTech going to be pressured to do the same? Time will tell.
I'll be honest with you. FastTech had their time, and FastTech is really behind GearBest these days. You know, I know from sales. I'll be honest with you. I used to do $2 to $3 million a month in sales with FastTech as far as product being sold. They don't do anything like that anymore, because people just they hate FastTech. I don't know why, but they hate it. But FastTech's main meat is nothing to do with e-cigs. It's all high-end electronics. It's phones and tablets and all kinds of crazy stuff.
Well, that's a really good point, Joe. We are the smallest little faction. Like, FastTech is huge, and we're the smallest little faction of what they do. Where I think GearBest very quickly went, you know, they brought in some vape stuff, and they saw the response and went, oh, wow, this is big. We need to do something with this. Right. So you may have a very valid point there.
But everybody who's like, don't go to them, they'll rip you off. Remember, you use PayPal. You're protected. Don't worry about it so much. You can just go, they didn't send me about shit. And then you can start the dispute process and you'll get your money back. So don't worry about it so much.
Now, of course, I would always encourage folks, deal with the vendor before you deal with PayPal. I mean, that's only fair to the vendor. Let them answer the question. But if you're not getting any satisfaction, PayPal is there to protect you. You're not going to be out the money. If it's not working out, if the deal goes south, you're protected. So that is a great thing.
Right. And so that is GearBest. Yeah. Just floating through the deals. And, you know, there are just so many coming out of just specific few websites that are just blowing the doors off everybody. I'm trying to look original without like seeming partial, but there is one. This has nothing to do with hardware. American.
Oh, shoot. And I'm talking away and I'm muted. So I apologize. I was saying somebody in chat earlier mentioned my little kitty here, my little buddy. And it's because my mic just looks so industrial. So, and to have it close enough to really work, I said everybody needs a little wild cat, right?
And then I responded. Yeah, I'm not gonna continue. Anyway, let's talk e-liquid. Let's talk some Vista Vapors. Now, Vista Vapors isn't the biggest and the best, but they are awesome. Well, they are probably some of the biggest, but this is a flavor I recently made. It's called Black Orange. This is from Vista Vapors. I just started vaping it. This is an orange black licorice. It's heavenly. It's just something you could do on their DIY area where you can add flavors and pick them and do what you want. And they'll send it to you. And you can name it anything you want. Like, I could have named this, Black Death. And they would have sent it to me, you know. But they're doing something really cool. They didn't do 10 mils before, but now they started it. And you can buy 10 mils from Vista Vapors for just $2.99. Any PGBG ratio, any NIC level, don't quote me on that. I mean, if you want like 24 milligram, I'm sure they're going to charge you a few extra cents. But you can get basically anything you want for $2.99 to try the juice. Now, I have to tell you, your apple pie, stunning. Wild berry, stunning. Green apple orchard, stunning. Really, really good juice over there. They remind me a lot of Mount Baker Vapor. You're throwing me off my game. You're blowing stuff on Tigers over there, and I'm watching you, and you're screwing me up.
Well, we can't interact the way we usually do because I've got a mute, so I'm just having fun in the background. You got to deal with it. I'm trying to break you still.
No comment. All I'm going to say on the breaking of Vapor Joe. Anyway, so, damn it, woman! Get over to Vista Vapors. I really, 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 really great juice vendor, and they have some really great flavors. So again, though, you can mix your own. If you want dill pickle and chocolate, they'll make it for you. If you want, something as simple as, you know, berry and chocolate, they'll make it for you. Or you can do their their pre-mixed flavors, which so far I'm really, really happy with. Alright, Tiger, you're making
it. Sorry, Joe. The problem is, you see, I'm not responsible. He brought me a glass of wine before the show. Now, you got to understand, I'm through half of it already, okay? I think he was trying to fit the whole bottle in here. So, you know, not my fault. It's all this guy.
No, but you have to understand, that's a huge wine glass. Like, that wine glass will hold half a 750. And I filled it to the top. Give the lady wine, and she tends to be, we'll use the word, compliant.
So, yeah, if the show goes sideways, you're responsible. That's all I got to say here.
All right. So, get over to Vista Vapors. Check them out, guys. You're really going to really enjoy their juice. And they are doing another thing where I don't have the link offhand, but you can get a free, I think it's a 12 mil juice for just paying the shipping for $1.99. But I do not have that off the top of my head. Alright. Let's see. What else is going on? You know, Tucker, we totally forgot about this.
Oh! What did we forget? Remind me.
We have a contest going on.
Oh my gosh! Yeah, we gotta talk about that.
For those of you who have your codes, you might as well throw them in there. For those of you who have your affiliate codes for the to get the extra entries, throw them in there. Vapor Joe's, the Vapor Joe's Network is giving away $1,000 to one lucky winner. Okay, so one lucky winner can win $1,000. Just get you y'all
And yes, while Joe looks for deals, someone asked me, is this actually a leopard? This is a snow leopard. Now, I know the name is Tiger, but I love all the big cats, and truly my favorites are the leopards.
Now, Albie has put a link in the room. And now, get over there. There's a bunch of people who put it in the room now. Get over there, and basically, we're giving away one lucky winner 43 days from now. You're going to win $1,000. No questions asked. You don't have to buy anything. There's things you can do to add into your entries, like come to our pages, follow us, do whatever. But currently, there's 111,304 entries with 43 days left. Now, the last contest we did was roughly about the same entries, but that was at when it ended. This is with 43 days left. We're looking at 111,000 entries. This will be the biggest, in terms of entries, giveaway in vaping history. And what we want to do on 12/12/2015, we will announce the winner live on Mod Envy. We are going to make one vapor's life a little brighter for Christmas. The vaping community. You know, we do like to give back. You know, my livelihood is made on the vaping community, you know, we like to give back to the vaping community. So, again, one lucky winner, $1,000, no questions asked. And if you are live here with us on Mod Envy when it goes down, I will deposit it in your PayPal account live.
And he's done that. We've known that from the last giveaway that, you know, he wastes no time in transferring that over. And I gotta say, I get such a kick out of you guys. Of course, you know, you're seeing the links in the room. You can create your own link to help, you know, share the news with other vapers and other folks and get some extra entries in the process. So I get such a kick out of what folks are doing to get people to click their links. We've got one in the room now that says it's Vapor Joe and Tiger Tiger's wedding night video leaked here.
I don't care how you do it. Don't bother me. You can be like, Vapor Joe fucking a donkey, done. Click here.
Nicely done. We have a sense of humor. Just... all we ask is, of course, in the other shows and other networks, just be respectful of the hosts. If they're allowing you to share, that's totally fine. But, you know, let's not push our luck. We want you guys to have fun with this, but just, you know, keep it common sense. Let common sense guide you.
Exactly. And, yeah, don't bombard people with links. But, you know, best way to do it, Twitter, Google Plus, Facebook, get it out there, and I promise you it's going to help you get a lot of entries, because I think each one of those, like, seven entries or whatever, five or six entries, so, you know, get a bunch of people doing it, and, well, you have a really great chance of winning, so.
And remember, you know, like, by all means, take advantage of all the ways to get extra entries. There's lots. Return daily for daily opportunities, but it only takes one entry to win.
That's right. I don't know who it was. Was it? All right. Last time we gave away $1,000, I broke it up into four winners. I believe Tiny Vapor won. We had, I believe it was Tom. Tom won from Vaping Underground. And then there were two other people who won. One of them won on a single entry. So you too can win on a single entry.
And I know Sean Mack in the room is a regular watcher, and I know you're totally cool teasing about being rigged. No, the fact is this giveaway is open to anyone in the universe except the two of us. The two people in this room are the only people that can't win.
Fuck,
so go for it.
No, I'm kidding.
Oh no, man.
Yes, Tiny One.
I would arm wrestle you over that one.
Okay. It's worth $1,000. Tiny won, and I was actually quite happy she won, because Miss Tiny Vapor, again, is, I don't know if she's in the hospital as we speak, but A couple days ago, she was going through massive contractions, and we may have a new addition to Mount Envy.
Absolutely. We got some messages Saturday that I was kind of hoping we would be sharing our anniversary with a little wee tiny vapor of sorts. And it didn't happen that night, so she's holding out. She's on her own schedule, and she will make her grand entrance when she's darn good and ready. Or she's induced, one or the other.
Bitch is doing the show. I don't care if she's pregnant. She's coming in. She's gonna be in labor. Well, of course, we're not gonna do Mod Envy this Saturday, of course, because it's Halloween. And I'm sorry. I love Mod Envy with all my heart and soul, and we couldn't do it last week because of the wedding. This week, sorry, Halloween on a Saturday. Love you guys, but Halloween's my favorite holiday. And I got shit to do, you know. So, and I'm sure 90% of the hosts that are with us have shit to do. So it's really, really important. But the following week we'll be back, and I'm hoping Tiny can come in live from her hotel room, stirrups and all.
From her hotel room? Is this a vacation she's on?
I'm sorry, from a hospital room, stirrups and all, and it should be fun.
Well, there is a question in the room that if you'll indulge me, Joe, I will field. And Holdout Tex wants to know, Tiger, how much different is Jersey from where you lived in Canada? In all honesty, I said to Joe the other day, with the turning leaves and the beautiful foliage and everything like that, the only thing different right now is that there's no mountain skyline no matter what direction I look. Right about now, the temperature is a little cooler here than I'm accustomed to for this time of year, but it's very, very familiar to me. And, you know, stopping talking about the place, let's talk about the people. I was warned that, you know, it was kind of a rough place and, you know, people wouldn't necessarily be friendly, and you've got to hold your own. You know, I've been out on my own a few times. Joe is so kind. He trusts me with his beautiful Hummer, and I've been allowed to jet around the neighborhood and outlying areas, so to speak, do a few errands. And everywhere I go, bar none, everyone is so unbelievably kind, friendly.
Because you're pretty.
They go out of their way. I don't know if it's the accent and they're just trying to improve tourism or what it is. But I don't understand where this unfriendly reputation comes from. It is a delightful place. The people
are delightful.
You
will never see a commercial for tourism. Come to New Jersey. It doesn't happen. Nobody says come to Jersey. It's awesome.
Well, you could, because seriously, everywhere I go, they're just fawning over me. People are, dying to help me.
Yeah, because you're good looking. That's why.
No, not the way I've gone out a couple times. Holy hell. You know, seriously.
Yeah, so, it's because you're you, Tiger. That's why they're nice. Trust me, the average bear goes, they get in a lot of trouble half the time, so. But yes, you have an unfair advantage because you're pretty, so that's why. Oh, there's Big Bamboo with the link to come to New Jersey. Yeah, thank you.
There we go. Yeah, absolutely. No, it is a beautiful place. I've said it a couple times now. Anybody, they warned me it's the armpit of America. Actually, some folks had a different choice of anatomy, and I won't go there. But I can only conclude you either haven't been here or you're just jealous.
Well, you know, there's a funny video out there. It's about 7 seconds. It's part one of those Vine videos where a woman is, like, in New York City, which is only about 40 miles away from where I live, and she's putting her hands up in the air, and she's like, "Hey, I'm in New York City. Welcome. I love New York City." And there's a guy. He's like, "Will you shut the fuck up, lady?" And it's just like, very definition of New York and New Jersey. It's perfect. Absolutely perfect. Beautiful. Oh,
you know,
has it.
They've got the link in the room. Thank you, Wrecker. Yeah. And you know what I realized? And I can't believe it, because I'm watching the monitor. I've been seeing myself through this whole broadcast. And I can't believe we forgot to mention some of our other vape mail, Joe. So I will field this one. Check it out. We got the Vapor Slam Swag.
Oh, shit. You're right. Hold on. I got to do something right now. Give me a second. As I leave the...
Oh, goody. That means I get both cameras. Ah!
I'm gonna do this because I'm gonna kick ass and everything.
Oh, I love the glasses. The glasses are absolutely good.
March, now.
People, book your rooms, book your time off, do what you gotta do. Vapor Slam, March. What? Help me with the dates now. We're talking.
I believe it's the 17th, 18th, and 19th. I believe.
The 17th is the Thursday. The actual event starts on Friday, the 18th. So 18th through 20th. So you guys, you know, do what you have to do. Book your sitters. Get your time off. Get your hotels. Make your travel plans. Be there.
Yeah, we got our hats. They sent us wonderful hats. Each one, Tiger Spin. Show them the name. Show them what's up behind your hat. There, yep, Tiger. Yep, it's perfect. Yep, came down. Yep. Yeah. And I have one that says Vapor Joe. They gave us these VIP bands. If all things work out, me and Tiger will be doing a seminar there about, again, doing a kind of a part two we did in the original one.
And to answer the question in the room, no, there are no pavilions at Vapor Slam. Now, for those of you who don't understand that joke, you know, New Jersey at Vape Expo, they had some unexpected problems come up. There was no vaping allowed in the event. A vape event with no vaping, right? And they were sending people outside to the pavilions to vape. Those pavilions, of course, ended up being airspace next to the dumpsters. So, no, Vapor Slam is a totally different event. There will be vaping in the event, and no worries, no pavilions. And Joe, those glasses, that is such a good look for you.
Well, somebody should take a screenshot and be like...
Well, the replay will be up by tomorrow morning, and definitely we can direct them to the minute mark where they
with my Caucasians t-shirt, which I love so very much.
Now does that require explanation? Because I'm Canadian, I needed an explanation on that one.
Well, I like Caucasians. What's the problem? I'm Caucasian.
Oh, come on!
What's the problem? You can
do better than that. Explanation.
Anybody who knows
this
shirt understands what the Caucasian t-shirt is about. It's basically with those people. I'm a giant fan, but I'm a big fan of people keeping the rights to say what they want to say, and they were trying to force the Redskins to change their name. And this is actually a Redskins shirt, even though I'm a Giants fan. And they changed their, well, they didn't change it, but it's just a joke on Caucasians instead of being the Redskins. But I walk around with this shirt, and people look at me like I'm some like white supremacist. I'm like, hey, fuck you! I'm Caucasian. I like Caucasians. Eat a dick. The problem here, buddy.
Like, you know, I'm just like I'm from Canada. I don't know nothing.
You know, but whatever, you know. But I just, you know, who turned me on to this was Freeze. He had it, and I was like, oh man, where'd you get that shirt? He pointed me over to the shirt, and I was just like, damn, gotta buy it. So I bought it. Oh, yeah, Foreskins would have been fantastic, too.
Oh, all kinds of wrong. Yeah, and Stubby Dan says the old Canadian defense, eh? You betcha, eh? You know all about it.
Oh, God. Eh?
So we are at quarter past the hour, Joe. Do you have any more deals you want to talk about?
Well, I just want to put a shout out. I just came across my screen. Damn it, Janet's birthday.
What?
Happy birthday, damn it, Janet. I just want to put it out there. It just popped on my Skype. So happy birthday to Damn It Janet. And she is part of my vernacular. If anybody knows me, will tell you. Every time I go, damn it, I go, Janet. So happy birthday, Damn It Janet.
Yes, he absolutely does. Happy birthday to you.
Yes, deals, yes. I have lots of deals. It is in my blood.
I never doubted you.
There's just the only problem is we have to make sure they're still in stock. Okay. Yes. Here's another one from Dear Best that I was really blown away by. This is the Clapper GT80. This is a 80-watt temperature control box mod for just $28.99. Unfortunately, no, I mean, I love the color. This is my color. But this is the pimp gold color only, okay? So I'm going to put the link in the room. There it is. Beat you to it, big man.
Only by a millisecond. That guy can read your mind, I swear.
But only the Pimp Gold version is $28.99 free shipping. Now, this is, does ship from China, but great box mod. 80 watts, dual 18650, a smaller design, but for $28.99, you can't go wrong. And, you know, like my iPhone, if I could pull it out of this, my iPhone is this color. My new iPhone 6S, love it. It in pimp gold. So this is my style of color. For those of you who want a different color, it's a few bucks more, but I don't know, just something about $28.99 for an 80 watt box mod. Well under 50 cents a watt. Fantastic, fantastic price. By a damn good company. Clapper makes a good mod. Like, I have the Clapper 30, and I have the Clapper 50. I do not own this one yet, but I'm going to order a few, and I'll just buy those for giveaways. And we'll call them the Pimp Giveaway. And it should be a lot of fun. So what do you think? 80 watts, Tiger, $28.99. What do you think?
Well, I mean, our original, you know, as wattages grew and grew and grew, we said, you know, don't pay more than a dollar a watt. Then the guideline was closer to 50 cents. And now you're talking about 80 watts for 30 bucks, less than 30 bucks. That's a great buy. That's hard to go wrong. And of course, Clapper isn't your highest end stuff, but I've had great luck with their stuff.
Still my, one of my favorites.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm thinking of when I say that, for sure. Nope. And, you know, even the original Clapper 30 treated me very well. So, great buy on that. 30 bucks, I would say you can't go wrong. And the fact that it's got the temperature control built into it, too, that's great value for your dollar.
Anyway, so great price. And like I said, my favorite Clapper of them all is the T6, which is the 100 watt single 26650. Tiger has one. I have a few. I have one that I use, and I got a few in the closet unopened. Love that mod, the single 26650 design, but not super, super accurate. You're not going to get a true 100 watts out of it because you're only using one battery. But the fact that it's using a dual 18650 design, you'll definitely be getting your 80 watts out of it. And temperature control, of course, for those of you who want to use that fad, it is available. And of course, free shipping. Now, if you're going to buy a bunch of these, just say you're going to buy three or four. If you're going to buy, so let me give you a little secret when it comes to GearBest. If you're going to buy something from them when you're ordering it from China and you're not using the USA warehouse, get the expedited shipping. It's going to cost you $6 to $8, but you're going to get it in like 5 to 6 days after it ships because it comes DHL. Now, this is for Americans. So if you're out there and you're going to be like, oh, man, I love this box mod. I want to order it for my shop. I'm going to resell it, you know, make a good bank on, you know, maybe double my money on it. Because it is still well worth $50. Don't get me wrong. Buy the DHL. It's going to cost you $6 to $8. You're going to get it really fast, and you don't have to worry about that China shipping. Anytime I buy from them, I usually use the DHL, which is the expedited ship.
There, I just wanted to bring up the T6 because, you know, we talked about it so much just now, and Big Bam was so kind as to share a link to the T6, and that's it right there. Still a great mod. No question.
Is it still available?
Well,
is it still out there somewhere?
I'm assuming so, because, you know, Big Bam, he don't play.
All right, so who won? I'm looking at it right now. Oh, Royals beat the Mets. Look at that. Royals beat the Mets. Pricks. Anyway, I'm from Jersey. I gotta back the Mets. Just saying. Everybody, how many innings did it go? Did it go 15? How many innings? 16 innings? 14 innings. Okay. Right, there you go. Well, hey, for those of you out there who are Royal fans, I guess you'd say good things are come to those who wait, but fuck you guys. I'm a Mets fan. I'm just I'm a New York Jersey fan, and I think baseball is incredibly boring, and nobody ever gets hurt, so it's not really a sport to me. If you can't go to the hospital, it's not a sport. Just saying.
Oh, okay. The level of injury determines level of potential injury determines whether it's a sport.
All right. We got 8 minutes in a room. How many in this room right now, if you're watching the Super Bowl and none of the teams are your favorite teams, do you root for injury? We just rooting for injury.
I root for injury all the time.
Just root for injury. That's what I do all the time.
Well, you know, there was a time, you know, as a Canadian, our biggest game is hockey. And there was a time, I understand what you're saying. The joke was I went to a fight and a hockey game broke out.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, you guys in hockey, hockey's incredibly insane. I mean, it's just they let you fight out there, which is great. I think that's, but I only like hockey if I'm actually at the arena. Hockey at an arena is incredible. Just insanity.
I'm almost ashamed. I fear they'll revoke my citizenship if I admit that I've never actually been to a hockey game live. But I mean, I was a fan. I'm not a sports fan anymore, really. I could care less. But I was a fan of hockey back in the days before helmets became mandatory. And I remember they used to throw down so seriously.
Well, you know, yeah. You guys up in Canada, you guys have some amazing hockey players, so I mean, that's just that. It's in your blood up there.
Alrighty. Well, unless you have something else you want to share tonight, Joe, deals-wise, we've got 7 minutes left on the clock to the bottom of the hour, at which point we will turn over the broadcast to DC. I see he's already in the room. And for those of you who haven't had the pleasure, DC, great host, great music, friendly, so helpful, lots of knowledge, and a real night owl. He's going to take you right on through until the coffee's on or until he gets tired, whichever comes first, and it's always a toss-up. So we don't want to run into his time, but we've got 6 minutes left on the clock for questions or another deal, Joe, if you got one.
Well, let's do questions. I do have one more deal, real quickie. Quickies are always good. Just super simple. This happens every month. Just gonna throw it in the room. This is for Yalik. Yalik always does a monthly. It's called his Deals of Steals. 100 mils of juice for just $11. Now for the month of October, his deals are cheesecake. We got some fruit stripe gum, pro pepper, which I think is a Dr. Pepper, a vanilla bean ice cream, blueberry cookies, and raspberry milkshakes. All very, very, very good juices. I know Tiger's had plenty of Yalik juice. I have plenty of Yalik juice. Yalik is a fantastic guy. Ships from Israel. He will ship you any amount of liquid for $10 worldwide. So don't buy just one 100ml bottle. Get a few to make the $10 worth it, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. That's rather impressive to me. And I know you receive your orders a little quicker. You're, of course, on the Eastern Seaboard. That only makes sense. Even in when I'm at home on the West Coast, considering it's coming from Israel, the shipping is reasonable in terms of the timing. Very reasonable. And you cannot beat $10. For those of you in Canada considering trying giving Yalik a try, do it. We can't even ship stuff domestically for the price he's charging for the shipping all the way from Israel. The juices, I haven't tried some of the more complicated flavors. I know there's more complicated ones. I've stuck to the more simpler flavors. And they are very, very simple, but great value for the dollar. Nice quality, good flavors. I'm just, you know, I got nothing bad to say about Yalik.
Yeah, his milkshakes are really good too. Now, I've had the blueberry milkshake. Really great flavor. It really tastes like a blueberry milkshake. The cookies milkshake I've never had. Somebody seemed interested in the room about it. I have no idea. Raspberry, I'm assuming, is going to be much like the blueberry with a raspberry flavor. But his coffee, he has a coffee milkshake that's just over the top. You know, think of it as like a really rich, thick, almost like a what are those, like an iced coffee that's been just whipped. Oh, it's just so good. All his milkshake flavors are great. But if you just want to go for the deals, they're $11. But I believe his regular price is,
It's 18 yeah. bucks for 100 mils, which is really reasonable. You're talking about cheaper than 5 mils for a dollar. So good buy.
Yeah, and you can't buy anything more or less than 100 mils from him. So if you're like, oh, I just want to, 30 mils, you can't. It's 100 mils. Now, he does have a sample. I could be wrong. He does have a sample section.
There was a sampler in the past. I haven't been there just really lately, so I'm assuming that's still available there. But the nice part is, when it comes to Gaelic, I suggest stick to your flavor profiles. Check the reviews. The reviews are excellent. All of his flavors have customer reviews on site, and they'll let you know how close he got it or how much they're enjoying it. And those reviews have been very helpful to me in ordering. And then venture out. When you reorder, try something new that you're curious about that you're not sure. And of course, check with other vapors. The good news is you're not out a lot of money. His prices are so reasonable that if you do have one that just, it's good juice, but it's just not your thing, share it, pay it forward, and somebody else can give it a try. And
not to mention, for those of you who are big Israeli supporters, I am. I love Israel. Gaelic is 100% kosher. If you worry about, all that, people are worried about things, maybe bathtubs and bodors. This guy is 100% kosher. So all good in the hood over there.
Exactly. Meticulous standards. Everything is literally kosher. So it's going to be very, very well put together, shall we say. Now, we are at 28 minutes past the hour, and there was a question in the room I would love to field. We talked about it a little at the top of the show, but somebody's asking, Joe, Tiger, what's married life like? Well, it's still sinking in, to be really honest.
I've been married 3 days.
Yeah, it's definitely still sinking in, and at this point, although the novelty has not worn off and I just love hearing it, my first gut instinct when I hear Mrs. Pettner is, Joe, your mom's here?
Yes, she is. Yes, Tiger is one of the... I'm so happy because, of course, I'm married and stuff, But the one thing I wrote is I stole her heart, and she steals my last name. So that's the most important thing.
Yes, indeed. And thank you, Condensation. Appreciate it. All you guys who've been so kind with your congratulations and well wishes, we appreciate it more than you know.
All right, we got to go because we got to have sex. And we'll see you guys later. And because we're married now, we're allowed to do that.
Oh, we're allowed. Oh, okay. All right. Well, then, it's bottom of the hour. So we're going to turn it over to DC. Thanks so much, you guys, for being with us tonight and laughing and hanging with us. And we will see you next week. Vape on, vape strong. Joe, any polite parting words?
you put me on the spot. Yes, we will. Happy Halloween, everybody, because we're not going to get to see you you guys on Halloween. So, happy Halloween.
I'll go with that. Happy Halloween, and all the best to you guys. Vape on, vape strong. We'll see you soon.
See you later.